Across sub-Saharan Africa, women make up the majority of the population in most countries. 51%, for example, in a place like Ghana. So any barrier to the optimization of their talents needs to be addressed. Now, a recent report by Ghana Health Service showed that between January and June, 3,000 plus teenage pregnancy cases were recorded in the central region, Cape Coast. Now, this particular figure indicates that a majority of such persons, or some of the individuals or the women or the girls who actually get pregnant and give birth, are unable to continue their education, which will affect their ability to optimize themselves, especially when it comes to their talent. So we've come to a community here in Accra, Bukom, to find out, I mean, when it comes to teenage pregnancy, what is the case on the ground? What is leading to, you know, some of these young girls, you know, getting pregnant, and what can be done about it? My name is Bobby Ose, and you're watching the City Newsroom. Now, we've been combing through this particular Ghana community. Currently, we are in Gbese, close to Bukom and Jamestown, and where we found one young lady who is 16 years of age in JHS2, and she is pregnant. We just want to find out what her story is and what led to her being, you know, pregnant at this young age.
I'm in class, form 2.
Yeah, you're in school.
Private, so that's in Lamte. I'm in JHS2. Screen clan yams, she beni a ballet, lockdown and a ballet war. Ufadu in your 1 year mask.
She be jail in a kufadu, Nikawaji, okay, in the Mukau.
If I bene cab, I ask when you war. What if it would make a be a piano and mum? Well, was school faithful, well, on your ask when she would make a bed, your fort, crack or young, well, no. Well, cat, Bebet mo here when come on come me true ta me wa he like come wa come ake wo mommy make wo kwa wo nunu wa school ba ma ka ke wo mommy make up amina ko ba fo alo o be ne bale lockdown e wo bebet mo gbe ke bi nyo ke li bi o.
Wow, I mean, what a touching story there. So we'll still try and speak to some more people, some more stakeholders, the parents themselves, because as the research shows, irresponsible parenting also contributes to these teenage pregnancy cases that we are seeing. So when you walk through the streets of Gbese and even enter some of the compound houses, you see a lot of kids such as these, you know, walking around. Some of them, you know, products of, you know, legitimate marriages. Some also products of teenage pregnancy. And I'm going to speak to one young girl here who happens to be 17 years of age, but currently has a kid. I want to find out what her story is, why she got pregnant, and what the future holds for her. Lilo, when did you wear?
Lilo.
Lilo, she means you're
Odole.
Odole, you're
here? Yes, 17.
Bien, Ofo. Minona?
Inanu.
Inanu. Omiye show yako nanu? Mini bunny on your but I mean, young girl to moving as anybody somewhere at school near Naka
because of our lockdown or not lockdown. Well, ask when you tell for them what she's
she bet boat in there, maybe for
as one year cool. My gift for if for September, I mean,
in one occasion, oh, for around this age, hello, I let oh, now queen, oh, for
now queen for
no, you know, like a became a papa. Like a cobbler, look or a cobbler, All right, so well, there you have it. I mean, she has a kid, and she essentially saying that the schools must be reopened so that the kids can go to school, so they do not engage in any risky sexual behavior, which will possibly lead to them getting pregnant before they are actually ready
to have kids.
Now, the role of parents as well as, you know, elders in the community when it comes to teenage pregnancy cannot be understated. Sometimes parents don't have the resources to take care of their kids, or they are not even around as much. So kids end up getting some of these things, attention as well as resources from some unscrupulous men, and then they become pregnant. Now, we're trying to speak to some of the parents. I have a lady here with me who says some of her kids have actually gotten pregnant. She's removed one of the pregnancies, and I just want to find out why she did it. No, ma, open it. Obiye ni amena teenage pregnancy.
Ibiye nyo, mokomiye le foreign lockdown ba. Mokomiye le lockdown ba. Nane yo.
Open it, amen yo family.
Money ba, money for 70 years. Money or 13 years.
13 years. Minimum 13 year old girl.
But my school, near school, better than my school, not my school, cock our mule war. Near school, in the dark beer toilet, can't cast any about. Never locked down my school. Cadia Nacoca may war. If I can ask you a war, Cadia Nabaman Tumpasa. Then I can't tell him be our gambler at 2 o'clock. It don't be a unal. Benny won't be woko. Sky as cool. Cadena neckas any about war. No one back of it there for you. One of go to Coneba. Now, by lockdown, what a lockdown, Iti. Walela, New York, Ghana, one of Koela. Katsaka, Korea, Ela, China, Ela, India. One of Koela, Ela, Ghana. Now, you will be a batalash for 6 months.
Oh, for 13 years, Billy, okay? Oh, Jimus, my boy, Jimus.
In your man, a furnace, a quaffite. No, I need your man, a furnace, a quaffite, and Yako Sukunda. No, I remember the bass, Sukun was an equence. Nikamula, ne four, but work where I for Kak, Paul, Nimula, Tasha, Matia Matole, Evanaka, Cob Bass, and Noah Sukun was an ambu. There be a back, but
no, Blanca, and you will hold the whole Ulile.
Ilala, 15 years, he can follow a year. A mamma came a billa school. Sam and Billa hang my paper. No, I'm mommy, so when I'm a billion four. No, I can't call him. I'm being.
I'm calling. Well, she be on a mini pot of bafi, kuni, eka, like.
No, I go. What bag of it? If I end my beer, I'm not meant to school. Now make my shit, I'm a joke. Kaja, now I'm just going to number Kasemi. Kato, I'm a bawa.
That's a very passionate mother there. I mean, two of her teenage girls have gotten pregnant. One has given birth, and one 13 years. Wow. Now, these old persons you'll be seeing, you know, very shortly, actually have been in the community for a long time, and they have some thoughts about the rising cases of teenage pregnancy. Now, are you seeing more young ladies, you know, getting pregnant?
Basa, ona. I'm a fair basa. I am in chono chono. What be? Na I'm in ye nunga. We can be in sex company. Have sex. Ona. Nesa anake. Noa nagba. Egba ona obi anewa.
So you're still watching The City in Newsroom. We're still focusing on the subject of teenage pregnancy, and we have a gentleman here with us to essentially, you know, delve deeper into, you know, research they've done about teenage pregnancy in some parts of the country. Mr. Kofi Asare, welcome to The City Newsroom.
Yeah, thank you.
Now, you did research across 200 schools, junior high schools and senior high schools. Teenage pregnancy, is it on the ascendancy? Are we seeing it lowering? Can you share some of the key highlights of your report?
We were concerned more about how to facilitate re-entry of these girls when they give birth, perhaps, you know, a year from now or a month from now, into the next academic year. That, for us, was the focus of our intervention. Because if you have a re-entry policy for pregnant girls, a policy that has been adapted by the Ghana Education Service, sponsored by partners including UNESCO, ActionAid, etc., and the policy is not working well, then it becomes difficult for girls to re-enter school. Let me give you an example. For the re-entry policy for pregnant girls simply says that if the girl is at a basic school, after giving birth, the girl should be readmitted to school and to continue. Okay, that is fine. At a secondary school, it is impossible for that to happen. Because when a girl goes to school and is in Form 3 and gets pregnant, okay, by the time she delivers and then gets to a point where she can return, there is a certain unique ID number given to you under the Free Senior High School. It makes your studentship valid for only 3 years. That is why repetitions are not allowed under the Free Senior High School. If you repeat, you have to pay your fees because the voucher is just valid for 3 years. And government pays your fees on the basis of that particular unique number, more or less a voucher. So if you get pregnant in Form 3, by the time you give birth, your colleague would have finished school. Your voucher would have expired. And so you cannot re-enter school. Apart from that, admission is centralized. The computerized placement is the main form of admission. Whether it is self-placement or otherwise, it is still centralized. It's not down at the school level. And so it makes it difficult to re-enter school, even if your ID, your 3 year, you know, have been expired. These issues were unearthed through our research, for which we are engaging the Ministry of Education on, to make flexible the admission systems under the Free Senior High School so that headmasters will be allowed to undertake admissions in communities or in schools where pregnant girls who want to return to school maybe next year will have access to that.
Thank you so much. Well, that's the head of the Africa Education Watch, essentially breaking down, the details of their new report. Essentially, more needs to be done across board from multiple stakeholders to ensure that the incidence or the prevalence of teenage pregnancy, you know, is reduced so that even after, you know, such young girls give birth to their kids, the systems are put in place for them to be able to reintegrate into, you know, the educational system for them to, you know, move on with their lives. You're still watching the City Newsroom.